We know well accustomed with the this company, Manufacture HP. They are printer producer. They initially or formerly were producing a spiral calculator, which is expected to be used by the scientists and the engineers only. Engineers. So that they feel that engineers and scientists can use very specialized functional calculators. So we are increasing or booming the price, they can afford it. The scientists or the engineers can afford it. So we are mainly or simply boom or raising the price so that some distinguished customers, some special customers can afford it. So on time onwards, everybody are feeling that product is very,
very good,
interesting, very special, so that they can purchase for certain prices. Even the price is reduced and above the competitors. This is for the scheme of the market. First, you can consume very delicious parties, and very special customers are also testing your products and having satisfied with that products. The rest of the market customers might be entered into the market. And what I have at last is the legal perspectives of the pricing policies. Legal perspective of the pricing policies. In fact, I expect our teacher will broaden all these ideas because they are very interesting when you reading, all of which are very interesting, and they need much more time. And they are in the books, they are supported with examples, but for the time being, I will simply say some on legal aspects of pricing of a product apart from the quantitative parties. So that legally, it was so prohibited to have some pricing tables. So that it is so prohibited to activate or to functioning price discrimination. Right? It is so prohibited, it's so illegal to discriminate different customers for similar products, to sell at different prices. Legally, this is prohibited. But there are some special conditions or some special situations by which you can discriminate one from the other of your customer. Taking the discount is also prohibited unless you consider quantity of the product that your customer are purchasing. For your customer purchasing a lot of products, you cannot a price discount can give because you are reasonable and you are supported with court. But with no case or with no reason, is so impossible to provide a price discount for all customers, for every customers, because you may be danger for the competitors, so that the competitors should stay in the market. For that case, for firing your competitors, for exiting your competitors from the market, you may discount for every customer of yours. That is prohibited by law. Legally, that is prohibited. So you are giving the discount, you are expected to give considering the quantity. And the discount related ideas are so important to be dealt in legal aspects of the pricing through price discrimination. And the other thing that I have is for discriminate certain prices of a product, of your product, you can have some expenses. You may incur, incur much more costs for delivering your product, leaving somewhere out of Jinmah, and you may incur lesser cost for delivering your product living in Jinmah. So that considering these differences, you can discriminate your customer using the prices. Using the prices. So that I have been prepared for some other remaining parts, remaining portion. One thing I left it for my friends and the other thing. I got somewhat difficulties on my instructions because I don't have WhatsApp. But thank you very much for listening this much attention.
Any questions? Any questions? Anybody want to ask? Please. You want to ask questions? Go ahead.
I think so. Those price penetration and the packaging are the strategies. So,
in fact, this price penetration and price scheming policies, as you know, these are not strategies, rather they are policies. And we know what a policy is, because in one of our class I failed in answering the strategy. And from then onwards, I get conscious in difference of policies, strategies, and the goals. So that these are the policies. These are the mechanism. These are ways how to achieving our goal. Yeah? How to achieving our goal. So that to achieve our goal here is penetrating the price, determining lesser price in the market. That is our policy. Our policy. The way might be different. The way might be different in determining the lesser price or which price might be different. But it is determining the least price of the market, the least price of the market. So that our strategy here is to find our competitors or to enable exit the competitors from the market. The market. So that we can revive from our least price of the market when the competitors are exiting from the market. And here is our policy here is to have the maximum price of the product. Considering our product is very distinct in feature, considering our special customers to afford that much amount of price, and testing the flavor of our special product generally is our strategy. And so that here our policy is having the very high or making very expensive our price, very expensive our price. So that we can determine in such a way based on the thinking, based on the policy that we have in determining the price, in determining the price. Probably in price scheming, in price scheming, it might be the monopoly or company. Our company might be monopoly. Anybody who needs my special product can afford this much high price. But for some other parties, for other customers which need a lesser quality of a product, can have some other lesser qualified products. So that, believe that we are so monopolized, we are so specialized in that special product, we can have some boomed amount of price with as I told you, the Hewlett-Packard, especially material producers of the calculator, they are proud of their material very highly, so that they can determine, they could determine practically very expensive price of the calculator, so that scientists and engineers are testing the calculator's efficiency and their problems. And though they are decreasing the highest price, they can sell still at a price just more than the market price. So that these are two different things.
So can you say that those companies that are following price penetration are able to charging their own price? Because there was the price.
This price penetration, this price penetration is prohibited by law. But there are some special conditions for having this price penetration. But by law, it is very prohibited, very restricted to exercise the price penetration. But when you have the direct raw material, the direct labor, the overhead costs at a lower price, maintaining the same markup, you can sell your product at the lower price, at the lower price. As far as you can maintain your markup, 43% or 186%, as far as you could maintain that one, because of the reduction in direct labor, direct material, and the overhead costs, you can reduce at lesser amount of costs, at lesser amount of costs. In such a way, you did penetrate those market costs, those market prices. And the other thing, if some other reductions are possible, if some other reduction in cost is possible, is also have certain price penetration. If you can have the lower direct material, direct labor, and overhead costs, you can have a price penetration. But this price penetration most of the time is for new product in future. For new product, the same is true for price scheming. For price scheming. Thereafter, you will adjust your pricing strategy, your pricing policy strategy.